Filipino-American and three other men were charged in the United States for an alleged terror plot. ABS-CBN North America Steve Angeles has tracked down the neighborhood where Fil-Am Ralph Kenneth DeLeon lives, and he joins us for more on this. Steve, what have you uncovered about Ralph DeLeon?
Well, Gigi, I'm at nearby the neighborhood in Ontario, California, where Ralph DeLeon grew up. Neighbors say the DeLeon family was a quiet family. It consisted of DeLeon's mother, father, and two siblings, a brother and a sister. I actually spoke to one of the neighbors who went to school with the younger brother. He said the DeLeons were a very quiet family. They would say hi. They were quite friendly, but they were also kept to themselves. And they did notice that over the past, in recent years, Ralph has gone through some changes. He was dressing more geared towards Islamic culture, towards Islamic beliefs, had more Islamic friends coming over to the house. And they were all shocked on last Friday when the FBI came in and raided the house. I don't know, they said for like a couple of days, it seemed like there were people casing the area, only for about 10 FBI agents to enter his home and with their guns drawn.
Steve, we understand that you were the first to track down the home of Ralph DeLeon. But what can you tell us about the rest of the family? Where are the parents? Where are his siblings?
The neighbors say, and it's actually one of the local newspapers had stopped by the neighborhood. And I was able to, one of the first TV crews to be out here in the neighborhood. The neighbors say the parents have not been around. They were unsure what the parents did for a living. All they could say, the parents were actually very quiet. Not too many people saw them or spoke to them. They would say that the dad was usually at home during the day, but the mom would leave for work early in the morning. And they say they have not been around since Friday's incident, although they see them coming in and out at night. So we're actually hoping to catch them sometime tonight if they do come by.
And so Ralph DeLeon has been charged in court. What do we expect next? What's going to happen next?
Well, there's actually a little uproar right now, especially among the Muslim or the Islamic community, as well as DeLeon's lawyer who spoke to the media. They have this feeling that this might have been a setup. After all, it was a confidential informant that gave this information that led to the arrest. So they're very skeptical of that. That informant was paid $250,000, and you know, it's assumed that he's expected to produce some sort of evidence or something to build the case against these guys in order to get that money. So the Islamic community, they're kind of just, especially the people at his mosque, are just waiting to see what the truth is. If all these so-called tape recordings and testimonies from this informant is true, if these kids were really planning on going out to Afghanistan to join the Taliban, as the affidavit says.
So there are people who believe it might have been a setup. Are there any groups who have offered any sort of assistance, legal assistance, financial assistance, any kind of assistance?
No legal assistance as of yet, from what I've heard. It seems that DeLeon, as well as the other two U.S.-based suspects, it seems they've all obtained a private attorneys to help them with their case. But after seeing what the attorney told the local newspaper out here, it seems like they're going to fight this.
All right. Thank you very much for that update. Steve Angeles there reporting.